Does anyone know where the Tinajas Atlas is? You? Holy smoke. Don't tell me there's somebody behind me. Holy. Do you know which way that is to the tanks? Nobody seems to know out here. We're just roaming around out here. Can you help us? Oh, looky there. U.S. Border Patrol, baby. He doesn't have a gun, but he's got his clips. He's ready to go. Looky there. We'll find it. He wasn't much help, though. He might have had a couple. Jay Shrek. I tell you what, you know, you get pumped up to do this, and I'm not going to tell you that I don't, but I'm going to tell you one thing. I am so pumped up today. You know, this is an opportunity today. If you didn't know where we're at by the intro right there, I'm going to tell you. I'm standing right now on the Mesa of Death. That is correct. I did say the Mesa of Death. We're at a place on the Road of the Devil that I've wanted to come forever. And this is a big, 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 big deal. We're gonna go up to the 9 tanks. And what we're hoping to do is go to all 9 tanks, but there's a petroglyph up here that's supposed to be probably the most important petroglyph in the state of Arizona. So, wish me luck. I've got a clue from an old article of 1940. Now, a little bit about this. If you were riding on the Road of the Devil and you got here and there was no water, well, guess what? You were probably going to die. There were over 63 graves down here of people that attempted, after traveling the Road of the Devil and came up to this, these watering holes, and were so tired they couldn't climb the 50 feet where water was and died right there. Now, one thing to remember too is back in that day, the technology, you know, the shoes that they had to wear, you know, we're rested today. I don't see it being a problem, even though I heard it's gonna get a little hairy. So we'll see, but you know, the technology of the shoes, things like that, and the fact that we hadn't hiked for 3-4 weeks and were exhausted and just completely worn out. So at one time, when you look across here, they said that the bleached bones of the people that died at this location, the Mesa of Death, was unbelievable. Now, Keno came down this road, and Diaz came down this road. At one time in its peak, this area would see 5,000 people in a year. That just goes to show you how vital this area was at one time. And the fact that, here's what's incredible to me also, is that, man, everybody was at this location. Everybody was in this valley. Everyone that was anyone in the Southwest came to this area. Now, in the late 1700s, the Spaniards noted they found a tribe of Indians here, Native Americans, that were naked, and there were 30 of them, and they documented them, and they were living up in this area. So when we go up there, we're going to find grinding holes where these natives were at. And this was around 1500, 1599, you know, 16, middle 16s, right? So, wow, I can't wait to get up there. There's grinding holes, and there's supposed to be a petroglyph that I've never seen photographed. So if we could find that today, if we could find that petroglyph, man, I'm telling you what, it would be one of those things that would probably be one of the biggest things that we have done as a channel, and me as an historian and an adventure seeker, have ever come across. I mean, most of the cool ones that we've seen, the supernovas, things like that, there's been pictures of them. I've never seen a picture of this yet. Most people don't know it exists. So we're gonna go up there, and we're gonna head up there, and we're gonna see how treacherous this really is, going up that groove to find these tanks. So Man, I can't wait. So we're ready to lace our shoes up and get to hiking. This is gonna be cool. I'm pretty stoked about this. It's the way we should have. But we're gonna work our way through these. And there's a path right there. And here's a lot of tracks right here. I mean, this is not a place that nobody comes to. So I'd be real surprised that, you know, if this magical blue pictogram, because it is painted, is up here, I tell you, be a pretty big deal if we could happen to run into this thing. So, man, look at the office today. Look what we got to work with today. And so I can already tell as I'm looking here how difficult these climbs are going to be. It's not going to be easy coming through here. So we believe that's it. I'm almost positive that's it, but wow. We will see. We will see if that's it or not. If it didn't, guess what? We have only taken today, the only goal today is to get up here. We don't have any other travel plans, so the whole show today is based on these legendary watering holes. And so the wording basically means high tanks. So everything is Spanish that comes through here. So what we're looking for is the high tanks. And from the videos I've seen, that's got to be it here. And can you imagine if you look across here, what you would see? I mean, all the wagon trains, all the different stuff. This is also considered to be the smuggler route still. Because, you know, water is just as important today as it was way back when. So it's still follow the water, but look at this. Tell me that isn't unbelievable. So this is not one you're going to... I hope this is a long one because we've got so much cool and interesting stuff to see. But they also say that they would find bodies with their fingers bloody because they were trying to climb and scrape up these slick walls. And you know, and their life depended on it. And the reality of it was not all of them made it back out. So again, 63 graves, deaths all over this. Over 2,000 people died here. And basically until about 1870, and that's when the Transcontinental Railroad came through. So they no longer had to worry about, you know, coming through here and having native problems and all kinds of stuff like that. Pretty good trail right here. So I feel pretty comfortable that we're on the right path. And again, this isn't a place that nobody's been. This is a highly touted trail, highly touted area. So I don't expect there to be, you know, this is not secret by any means. I've never followed the trail to get here before, but this looks like the way it's gonna go. So when they made their way through here, they're walking the exact same trails, you know, conquistadors walked their way through here. Look at this, isn't this incredible? Just incredible. So you can already kind of see what we're getting into right here. It's all kinds of stuff. Looks like it's gonna be a good bouldering day, and I like to boulder, so I'll tell you what, we got a hike ahead of us. I don't even know which way to attack that, to be honest with you. So this is just gonna be, and they say 50 feet to the first tank, and that people would be dead at the bottom of this tank. They couldn't get in here. So looky here, we've got a first tank right here. I expected it to be a lot taller, a lot farther up than this right here. Somebody's left some goods there. And then the rest of it is just figuring out how we're gonna work our way through here. That's pretty steep. That's gonna be an interesting climb. It really is. I'll find a way to get across. And that kind of looks like maybe, but you know, it's gonna be difficult when you jump across to figure out where you're gonna go. But there we are, there's the first tank. I'm pretty stoked, so A lot of times I'm gonna have to put you in a pocket, because if you see, that is a steep tank. Those are steep walls. We're gonna head that way. Now it looks like you can go up that way or across that way. We're gonna go up there and see if that's our journey. Try to do this smart and see where we're going. And this should be ridiculously cool today. But there's the first tank. Well, I'm starting to huff and puff a little bit. There's why I came down. One thing I wanted to show you was this right here. Okay, that's a steel rod. They used to have cables. They used to come down this hill and used to be able to pull a cable. Now, I'm gonna tell you, that's steep as shit. So let's just not even fool ourselves. And we still gotta go up there. And we're only at tank one. You know, we got one tank down. And I'm telling you what, it ain't for the weak of heart, and it ain't for the ones afraid of heights, because we just got this started and there you are. But you know what? So now you get it. So let's just say you came here and you've traveled for 3-4 weeks and you're about ready to die because you haven't got water. And the first tank's dry, because everybody would have hit that first tank, right? And the animals. So it would have been completely dry to most people. So here we are. And you got to get to tank number two. And all I know is tank number two is higher than tank number one, right? It makes common sense. But already, this is why they died down here. This is why there were 63 bodies of men buried down here. And this is why the horses and the, you know, the sun-bleached bones were everywhere, for this very reason. Now when you get up here and you talk about this stuff, you definitely get why it is what it is. This is why we're here. This is the whole purpose. So I'm gonna put you away again, because I'm telling you what, it's not crazy, don't get me wrong, we're not death-defying, but if you fell down this, you'd be jacked up. You would be in a bad shape. You hit your head at the bottom, you know what? You'd be 64, right? Our goal is not to be 64 today. So if we look down there, we come across that point right there, and we are getting ready. Now it looks like that's number three down there. Number two right there. Kind of two pools, but I'm gonna say that that's two. And then three will be on up this ridge. And I'm trying to find a good line. You know, if we kind of go across, you know, from here. And here is first graffiti, J. Duncan, April. I don't know if that's 93. That's the first I've seen of any graffiti. I'll tell you what, so far, you know, I'm not gonna say it's scary, but I'm also not gonna tell you that it's like super comfortable. So we get into here also, and guess what? These rocks are wet. That really makes you feel good. So we try to work our way over. I don't know if it's better to kind of go down and work around or over here. But boy, you want to make sure you got your shit together. It might just be damn near as easy coming up that center and trying to skirt this edge over here. So I'm not even sure about that yet, of what was smarter or not smarter. It's kind of a cool hole. Look at that. It's interesting. So even this is not a big deal, but it's like, okay, what am I going to do? Am I going to walk over and then come down there if I have to? Well, I think so. Tell you what, holding this camera, bringing you guys along is a hell of a lot of fun, but it's not always the most comfortable, to be honest with you. So it's one thing to haul this thing with both hands. It's also another thing to kind of slide down in here and have one hand to do it. So aqua chigger, I get it. So there is another one. So I don't know if you'd count that. I would say you'd count that as a water hole. So I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3. Now what that means is between 3 and 4, somewhere in here is a crevice that should have a petroglyph we're looking for. And you know, I don't know where exactly that's at, But even right now, I can see when people say that you're like, which trail to take? Man, it's kind of weird, okay? Which direction do you go? Because there's not a clear path. Okay, right down there, we're gonna go that's number three. We're gonna kick through here. We're gonna try this valley and see if the valley is a little easier than trying to traverse over them hills. You know, this is a, I'll tell you what, it took about 2 minutes for me to figure out why they died. Okay, that was about it. That's about all it took. Figure out why they died. Now we're gonna start really looking hard, because if that's three, it's up here between these. And so we're gonna hit on up that and then loop around and try to do this the smart way, you know? Try to do this the smart way. See if, you know, I don't wanna miss anything though. If there's any glyphs, I'm gonna try to look at these walls too, to try to see if there's anything else down here. And I'm gonna have to put you guys away, because we got mountain goat climbing up here. On the adventure scale, this is a good one. This is absolutely a good one. So, you know, all these crevices, these could definitely, that could be in any of these. You know, just to let you guys know here, looking down in here, and you know, the thing is, I've got to get in here to see if I can find, because I'm told that kind of how I understood it was that the petroglyph was going to be on this wall. So, you know, wherever it was at. So it was going to be upside down on top, like on the ceiling. So, you know, if it had been easy, somebody else would have found it. So there's a reason that I have not seen it. Oh man. So let's get on up this hill. But we're gonna start trying to make sure that we really look at anywhere that they could have laid underneath and put that in there. Cause that really, finding all the tanks is not really my main goal. My main goal is finding this petroglyph and getting as far up as I can do safe, and to see anything else that I might see up on these walls that maybe other people haven't seen. So we'll try this measure of hiking the creek as close as we can and see where that gets us. Well, here we go. Here's tank number four. Look down there. See the grinding holes on that rock down there? So they were setting up in here. I'm gonna get you down in here. Grinding holes right there. We're gonna take a look at number four. So those glyphs are supposed to be over here somewhere. Nice grinding hole. They did a lot of work up here. This looked pretty interesting though, because it looked like it went back. So, wow, look at that. Still pretty deep. Wow, look at that over there. Big rock dude there. So there's number four right here for sure. So there's five left. Now these glyphs are supposed to be somewhere in here. So where they're at, and I'm telling you, that looks like a glyph up there, but I can't tell. I'll be walking. I'm gonna make my way up that ridge. Well, tank five is right there. We just came up that steep ass hill. So, you know, I've had a couple slips with my shoes, which are usually, I mean, pretty damn bulletproof. But definitely, it's a challenge. I'm not gonna tell you it's not. You know, I almost don't wanna go down to five, because I wanna kind of figure out how I'm gonna get across to six. So, you know, I'm trying to figure out that. I don't want to get too far into that, because, you know, I still got to go up, and man, there ain't a better way over there that I can see. So we're pretty much on the path, and the only other way is to go straight up there. And That's gonna be a journey. Let's get back up here and see what we got. It's gonna be a journey. And then you gotta shoot across that little top. I think it won't be bad coming down. You kind of get into this trough. So we're gonna do this smart. And it looks like number 6 is right there. Right over there, if I can just get across that top. Right there should be 6. So, I should be looking at these caves too as I'm going up here, but that's a steep son of a gun right there. I'm telling you, I'm gonna do a little ass sliding on that there for sure. I think I'm fine going up this groove though. That's some vertical there, I'm telling you. Probably the best way to be across that, but then you fall down there, you're gonna be jacked up. I'm planning on getting jacked up today. Yes, sir.
Everything okay? How are you?
I'm at 5 right now, and I think I can see 6, but man, you talk about straight up.
Be careful. Take your time.
Oh, yeah, you can't play up here. This is like, I'm getting ready to go up a ridge right now that's sheer strong. I mean, hell, it's damn near climbing, but, you know, it looks like a safe path, so I'm not too concerned about it. It's going to be harder getting down than up. I gotta come down, so better think about this shit before you go any higher. As an explorer, you're always wanting to get to the goal, whatever the goal was. And there gets to be a point where you just go, I tried this rim up here, man, my shoes aren't holding. I tried this rim up here, and my shoes aren't holding. But the last thing I ever want to do, no shit, is let you guys down. Because I didn't climb all the way up here to say stop, but as you get to a point where you definitely know, but there's got to be a time that you just go, okay, this ain't making no sense. And I feel really disappointed, man. It's kind of like I went up the 3 different ways because I'm like, man, the last thing I want to do is come up here and fail, regardless of any mission that we go on, whatever the journey or adventure is, right? But there's a point where you go, okay, there's my point where, you know, I had a worse time getting up wasn't as difficult, but then I'm like, okay, now you got to get down. So how's that going to be? And you're like, damn, wow. And you know, I've never ever gave up on an adventure yet. I have not. And you know what? I think I've come to the point where, you know, I'm not going to go higher than tank 5. You know, I just don't think it's smart at this point. And you know, a better man than I, and you know, the shoes, they're not holding like I wanted to hold. If you're going to come up here, man, make sure that your shoes, you got your new pair out, because I'm telling you what, this was a difficult deal. Now, what we are going to do is we're going to go down and we're going to see if we still can't find the petroglyph. So I'm going to take this time that I would have spent trying to get to the top. And, you know, could I have got up there? Yeah, but you know what? If you're doing this by yourself, man, you want somebody somebody there with you if you're going to climb this. I mean, Nakwichigger got to a point where up here he also decided, you know what, I should listen to him. So Bo, sorry about that. But what a great adventure regardless. I'm not mad. I still got to get down. And, you know, it's not going to be easy even sliding down what I've came so far. But, wow, incredible journey, man. I'm not, you know, I've got to be smart because I want you to be smart. I want you to make good decisions when you do this stuff because, you know, last thing you want to do is slide down there and cause a lot of people a lot of problems because you got to know when to be not stupid enough to make sure that you get to go fight another day. And we're not done yet. We're going to the bottom. I'm going to try to find that pentacle. That's the real reason why I came here. Yeah, did I want to get to the top? Hell yes, I did. And I'm super disappointed, but I'm also like, come on, Jeff, be smart about what you do. This is not time to be stupid. So we're going to go see if we can't find that petroglyph and make sure that this show still goes on. And, man, I still got to get down. I'm telling you what, that ain't going to be easy. So we're still in adventure land, and I'm still pumped up. I'm disappointed as hell, but I'm going to make the call to be smart, not stupid. And that's hard for me to do if anybody knows me. Stupid is more down my line. Let's look down in here. I don't see any glyph in that area. I wish I had a little better understanding of my little blood today. So it's hard to tell where that crevice was at. I don't really have a clue where that would be. I'm trying to think of it, maybe up that ridge. It's hard to say. There's just not that, I say there's not that many places, but there are that many places. There are a lot of places that you can be looking for this stuff. Several stops. Tell you what, there's plenty of places to find adventure in here. There's no doubt. That water looks pretty good right there. Looks really good, actually. Let's give this a stretch. Man, I don't know if I went down there or not. That's the problem is, once you commit, oh, I got myself in a pretty weird position right there. I need to switch feet. There we go. Water here. Well, I've lost my sunglasses somewhere. And I don't even know where I even was at where I would have. I'm thinking maybe that area up there where I had to get down to get the water bottle. So, really didn't want to lose them. So, if they're not there, not up here, I don't know where in the hell they'd be. I don't remember oh, look. Dumbass alert. Dumbass alert. Right there.
Everything okay?
Well, I don't know if I can get across. I might have to climb back out if I go this way. Hard to say what I've got to do. Well, Maria's got a feeling. And she's got a feeling. I'm gonna work my way over here. I don't think it's enough to have got anybody under there. But kind of thinking like, I like what she's saying though. I kind of like the thought of maybe something being under there. This is where I'm hanging off of right now, if you want to see. And I don't see anything. Okay. Holy shit. Holy shit. Holy shit.